solar-powered phone charger for our project. We chose this project because it deals with the matter of communication, which is an important thing in society today.
Our theme is going forward. This will really help the society in efficiency.
We might experience a few problems, such as cutting the wires too short or calculating wrong measurements.
Also, we can experience teamwork issues, such as not all working together or somebody taking over.
We will make sure to have a surplus of supplies and that we all work together as a team.
Hope to see you on STEAM Night, which is Thursday, May 4th, 2017. It's in the middle school building in the atrium.
Hope to see you there.
And I'm Nathan. Today we'll be speaking about our STEAM project. We are doing a spinner machine.
Some questions we wanted to know are when the spinner machine was created and who invented it. We also want to know why it was invented.
We were wondering if there were any major events going on at the time the spinner machine was created.
We've had a little bit of a hard time researching the spinner machine because it is not the most well-known.
We chose this spinner machine because we thought that it would be creative and original and no one else had done it.
Then what we did was we researched all the things that we needed to make our build. Then we wrote it down and gave it to Mr. Hans so he could buy the things we needed. Next, we did our budget.
Once all our supplies got here for the spinner machine, we started working. After we started working in our class, we started making our trifolds.
After that, we will be ready to present our project on May 4th, 2017. So some of the problems we faced were researching because the spinner machine is not the most well-known, but we can fix that by making our questions smaller and less complex.
Another problem that we might run into is time management, but we can fix that by using every class time efficiently and working hard.
Our final problem with the spin art machine can be our build, because the spin art machine is long and complex and may not be the easiest thing to make. We can fix this by working hard and making sure everything is where it needs to be and following all the directions.
I think the outcome of this project will be really cool because we challenge ourselves by doing the spin machine. Also, I think the finished project will show all our hard work and time that we put into it.
Also, since the spinner machine has a lot of color, our project will really stand out.
Thank you for watching our Smes Talk. We hope you enjoy.
Shoebox with tinfoil. Another step is using dowels to hold up the top of the shoebox. Another step is drilling a hole in a Pringles can, and one more step is covering both of them with saran wrap.
We will expect to run into many problems. Some of them are we cut ourselves with the scissors, we may catch the tinfoil on fire, and the food may get burnt. We expect to solve these problems by being careful.
We expect in this project that we'll be able to cook decent food in our solar ovens. Come on May 4th at 6:30 to see our solar ovens on STEAM Night.
Thank you!
project is the catapult.
We chose this project because we were very fascinated in their early war strategies.
The theme is moving forward and represents this in two ways. The fact that whatever it is launching, it is launching it forward, and it shows how much battle strategy has changed since catapults.
We really like the way it's built and how interesting it is.
We all had to research. We found that it came from the Chinese, Greeks, and Romans.
The word catapult came from the Greek word catapultos.
There are four types of catapults: attention, gravity, electric, and torsion.
We all had some difficulties. Someone accidentally filled out the ledger wrong, and we all thought this project would look really cool.
We all think our project will turn out great because we all worked very hard. We put a lot of time into this. Catapults are a huge part of our history.
Thanks for watching.
Hi, my name is Jackson.
Hi, my name is Will.
My name is Trey.
And our project is a bouncing robot. Unfortunately, we're missing Henry because he is out sick.
Our background research is about how the motors will work and function, and we have summarized some information from some websites online to get that information about how our robot will work.
The process we have to go through is cutting the straws into 5-inch pieces, and then we have to cut little slits into each of them to tie the rubber bands in. And then we have to add the motor, and then we have to wire the motor to a switch and wire the motor to a battery. And we might face some problems, such as
the motor could explode, the straws could be cut in half and cut too short, the rubber bands could get cut too short and stuff like that. And also, our wire might not be stripped correctly and then it wouldn't work. So there are a couple of problems we might face.
Our expected outcomes of this project is a fully functional bouncing robot that would vibrate and start bouncing. We also would expect our trifold to be colorful and beautiful. Thank you for watching.
See you May 4th.
I'm Jane.
I'm Ansley.
I'm Luke.
And I'm Lauren.
Today we are going to be talking about a steam fair project.
We are making a solar panel car. Even though other people are making solar panel cars, ours will be special. Our car is going to be 3D printed.
We are super excited to begin working on this project. We had a hard time cooperating and deciding on what to do and how to make it.
Also, the measurements were a huge problem. They were making us think that maybe we made the wrong choice.
Lastly, some of our members had some fights and disagreements that others had to help with solving.
Eventually, we solved all of the troubles and problems.
First, we will design a 3D print on Tinkercad.
Then we will print it in the computer lab.
We will also add the battery, fan, and solar panel.
Then the wheels.
Well, we hope you have a good day. Bye.
And don't forget to visit us on May 4th in the atrium.
And my name is Brady.
My name is Antonio.
And my name is Abbott.
Our group is making a film canister battery that will hopefully power an LED light.
We did a lot of research to know the best about our battery, which is the film canister battery. We know it works both
from a chemical reaction between the zinc nail, the copper wire, and the white vinegar. And we also wanted to know the history. The first battery was built about 2,000 years ago, but they didn't know exactly how it worked, but it was around the same technique. They knew it powered energy. And we also researched about different parts of our everyday battery, such as the lithium. Once the lithium runs out, the battery doesn't work anymore. We used many websites to find all this information, but a good one was scienceonline.org. And we know a battery works because it can charge up something, it can shut down, and it can be connected to another electronic. And any technology of some sort of battery can change the world.
So what we did to build the battery was we took a film canister and we drilled two holes in either side, and we put a zinc-coated nail in one of the holes and a copper wire that we stripped in the other hole. So for testing, we clipped alligator clips to the nail and to the wire, and then the wire for the alligator clips ran into an LED light. So we were testing to see if we could power the LED light. Now what we'll do when we actually present it is we'll melt the wire, instead of using alligator clips, we'll melt the wire to the nail and to the wire so the signal goes easier.
We might run into some problems, like the battery might erupt with this oozing brown copper hardened vinegar. And if we have too much power, another thing is if we have too much power in the battery, and with four batteries, it might pop the LED light. Another thing is if we don't have much power, it will not power up the LED light.
We hope to power in a red LED light or just any LED light with four of these film canister batteries, but the more batteries we add, the brighter the light will get. So we're hoping to be able to light the light in a dim room, but not a dark room.
Thanks for watching.
Hi,
my name is Rocco.
Hi, I'm Ava.
Hi, I'm Davis.
Hi, I'm Riley.
Hi, I'm Brendan.
Our project is on the water clock. We were thinking about building this project because it seemed really interesting because people from the 1500s used this to track time.
Our group couldn't believe that people from such a long time ago found a way to keep track of time.
There are many steps to making our project, the water clock.
So far, everybody has contributed.
First, to build the water clock, we need to block any holes in the bottom of the flower pot so water doesn't drip down.
Next, we will fill the water pot with water. Next, we will fill the flower pot with water and let it drip run out.
Then, we will put the dowel to the eyelet strips and take the cork
that we bought with our debit card to the bottom of the jar.
When we start the water clock, it will steadily drip at the exact time of 1 minute. We have not experienced any major problems yet, but we think the trifold will be hard to design.
Another problem is whether we should start measuring the time on the cork or add a wooden platform so we can start on the dowel.
We think that our project will drip from every drop from 1 minute.
Another hope for our project is that it will stand out from other projects at the STEAM Fair.
We hope you learned a lot about the water clock.
Thank you for watching.
This project goes
well with the theme moving forward because we use them all the time even though we don't know it. We chose this project because it will be really fun to build, and also in past wars they have used catapults to launch bombs and shells.
We are doing this project because we think it's very fun and very convenient, even though it's not on the students' list.
Many mistakes we have had are from our budget, because wood, eye hooks, and bungee cords are very expensive, and we did not do a project for Mr. Hayes' catalog, so that will be very complicated.
Today I'll be talking about the main steps of our catapult. So first, you will make a first base shaped upwards, and then you'll make another rectangular base out of wood. You will attach the first base to the second base, and then you will make your swing arm and attach both of those to the bungee cord.
Our outcomes are very good. We have had some problems working together, but we have figured them out.
Thank you for your time.
Hi, and welcome to Smes Talk.
My name is Chase.
My name is Catherine.
My name is Elle.
My name is Ian.
My name is Liam.
And our project is the homemade penny battery.
We chose this project because it's very interesting to all of us, and we wanted to learn more about how electricity started.
We researched how the battery works, how it helps the environment, and also how the first battery was made. Also, we got some of our research from batteryuniversity.com and other amazing websites.
I figured out that the original battery is just like ours. It has the same supplies, but it's differently laid out.
We also found that the battery helps the that a regular battery helps the does not help the environment because it takes a really long time to decompose.
I found out that a chemical reaction occurs in a battery, which turns into electricity.
A big problem that we saw when making this was it took a long time to sand the copper side off of the penny. We fixed this problem by having multiple people sand multiple pennies at once.
The steps that we are taking to finish this battery is that we have to shave one side of the battery, soak the cardboard into vinegar, place aluminum foil at the bottom, and then place all the cardboard and pennies on top of the aluminum foil.
We're all so excited for Steam Night and very excited to see all the amazing projects and show our friends and family our projects.
We are all a little nervous to show our family and friends our projects, but we are ready.
We hope you'll see our projects.
Thanks for watching.
How to make the camera and how the camera works.
We will be researching about the looks of the camera and the lens of the camera as well.
We buy all of our supplies from the same Martin's debit card. I think our project will do very good because it's interesting, and the first 200 people to get there will get a picture of themselves.
I think that it is also very interesting because it is cheaper to buy and it's just reusing basically the parts that you can get for a cheaper price to make a camera that you could buy that's more expensive, but you can use it for a cheaper price.
For this project, we would need to be okay with failure because it's not easy. Our problems right now is finding the supplies for the printer and finding the supply or how to build the holder for the Polaroid camera. I think in the future we will have problems with the printer.
Our team goals for our Polaroid popsicle stick camera are that we get it done and that it prints and takes pictures successfully. So we are very excited for this team grant to go our camera.
How we're going to make the holder, as we're thinking, is to take a piece of thick piece of rectangular piece of wood, cut a rectangle in the middle of it out so we can put the film in the middle of it. Then we will make them take another piece of wood, put it into the cutout piece to make a slide so the piece of film in the camera won't get any light in.
This camera, as Sophia said, is hard, and as Wesley said, is hard to make. But with the film and the holder, we are thinking of making the platform for the holder made out of popsicle sticks, as it's shown in the picture. And the front and the surface are also made of popsicle sticks. But the film and the camera as well are also very hard to make. So that's one of our disadvantages. It's been taking a long time to figure out. We don't know how to operate it correctly.
Thanks for watching.
And I hope you come to our STEAM fair night to see our Polaroid popsicle stick camera.
Hello, our names are
Walker, Whit,
Wyatt,
and John.
And we're going to talk to you about our solar-powered walker. We chose this project because we thought it would be fascinating to learn about solar power. We decided to do a walker because we didn't want to do a boring little car.
We got all of our information from the Safe Harness database. We need to know what the future, what the past, and what the present is. And during our research, we found another research question, which was, what are UV rays and how do they work? And this helped us because we didn't want to put blind information that we did not know about.
The first thing we did while working on this project was write up a proposal. After that, we got to research. The next class, the pieces to our walker came. So we started the build, and during the build, we ran into many problems.
One stagger problem we had was there was not enough power to power the motors with two solar panels. We needed 8 solar panels, but that cost way too much money. Mr. Hand said it was his mistake because he did not check the power, so he bought us higher amped ones for the same price. Another snagger problem was that our motor could overheat. We fixed that by buying 2 motors in case one overheated. The last problem we could think of was we could lose something wrong or backwards. We fixed this by checking our work before we glue them on.
We think that the outcome of our project will be that our walker will be able to have enough power from the sun to power its engine, and that it will be able to walk across the ground at a sufficient pace with the help of our gears that we added.
Thank you for watching this Smes talk. We hope you enjoyed, and we're out.
From my heart and from my hand, why don't people understand my intention?